everyone. Today is Tuesday, August 18th, 2015. And yes, Scott Hallam, it is Tuesday.
It is Tuesday. We're almost live.
Welcome back. We are live
it
here.
It is Tuesday.
It is Tuesday.
Oh, we have a caller on the line.
Yes. Who's the caller? Mike Antonelli?
Mike Antonelli. Hello.
Scott Hallam joining us. Heather Tuey making a return. Heather Tuey. We haven't seen you in a while.
No, it's been a minute.
It has been a minute. It's been a few minutes.
Yeah.
But welcome back. This is not Cheryl Davies sitting here.
No.
As we had promoted here. Cheryl Davies had a back out at the last, minute here. So, Heather, Phil, jumping right in. So, thank you, Heather, for joining us here. You're in the midst of moving.
I am. Like, literally in the midst of moving. Yeah. So, I'm sorry if I'm, glowing. It's a healthy sweat from...
You are glowing.
...hauling things. Yeah.
A little tanned.
Well.
You're shining off of Scott up there.
Not as tan as Matt.
No.
No. Now, I've been out in the sun.
Spray tanning.
No, spray tanning.
Yeah, I agree, Scott.
Yesterday, I went to Lake Taconic.
It's almost orange.
The flying tomato.
I went to Lake Taconic. I was over in Lake Taconic on that hot day, and then last week I went down to see my sister.
Nice.
She lives in Long Island, so I was down on the beach for
a few
days. Oh, I
saw the pictures on Facebook.
Yeah, see? I'm all over social media with that. So it was nice. It was a little hot yesterday, though.
It was nasty. I was at a golf course.
Yeah, it was brutal.
Disgusting.
It was brutal.
Thank God for AC.
Yes. Now, I wanted to start off, first of all, before we move into our regular show here, my thoughts and prayers go to Wendy Casalino. Wendy, I don't know if you heard, her father passed away over the weekend. Maybe Thursday or Friday, I forget when it was. But Wendy has been here with us many times. Mm-hmm. We've gone to do Zumba with her. And her mother always watches the show as well. She always comments on the flowers I have in the background. That's why we have no flowers here, Linda. So my thoughts and prayers to them on this tough time that they're going through. So I just wanted to mention that. We're thinking about them. But anyway, Heather Tuey... What's new with you?
Well, I got a promotion.
You got a promotion?
Yes. I am now Assistant Manager of Culinary Services at Mulligan's Pub.
Wow. And we went up to Mulligan's.
Yes,
we actually mentioned that. Yes. We had a little summer flashback moment to that a few weeks ago. Well, we mentioned you, and we took a little video clip up there.
Yep. So with that promotion, that means I will not be returning to the elementary school.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Breaking news.
Yep.
Breaking news is right, because I thought for sure you'd be in the
that
fourth
was the
grade
news
again.
That yeah,
you wouldn't
no.
tell me. Yeah.
That was the news that I had to break to you. No, it's not that I'm pregnant, because I'm not.
Well, I thought that's what it was. That was the news the last time.
No. It is more a little sad. I mean, it's bittersweet.
No more little Heather.
I'm going to miss working
around
at the school. But on days off, I can still sub, so I'll come in.
Okay.
And I'll still see you guys.
Wow.
But it just won't be...
Well, I hope you're still going to be able to co-host here, too.
I'll still be able to co-host.
Okay,
yeah,
wow.
I get days off.
All right.
They're dropping like flies around here.
So. I know. Co-hosts are dropping like flies around. What is going on here? What is the problem with Matt? I'm harmless over here. Please. I mean, I don't understand this. But anyway, that's good. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
That's very nice. We're going to miss you at the school, though, of course.
I'm going to miss it, too.
I was hoping you were going to be in fourth grade. I'm still waiting to find out who's going to be in my room.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Nobody's telling me anything around here.
Maybe they don't know yet.
I don't know. I mean, I need some help, Scott. They always put somebody in there with me to kind of keep me under control.
I'm sure they're fighting over it. I don't want to be in there. Me either.
Yeah, I'm sure. Now, what's new with you?
Nothing.
Dr. Gash?
We went on a big camping trip this weekend.
Wow.
Yep. All the guys.
Oh,
yep.
All the guys.
All
not
the guys.
Stacy?
Stacy
stayed home.
No, this
Stacy
was.
Stacy stayed home.
Gun shooting, beer drinking.
Wow.
Championship. Yep.
Wow.
That's all I can tell
fun
you.
Fun kind of camping trip.
Yeah.
That's all I can say.
Wow. That's all you can give us some information.
I can't give
about
any more
it's
information.
It's like Vegas.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm. Next time I'll wear a GoPro.
That'd be kind of cool.
Did you bring an air horn with you this week?
As a matter of fact, I did.
Oh, God. I don't
and
know
you
if you
have
saw
no
it the
idea
last time.
No.
You are the only person that's. It was the greatest
live
with Matt of all
time. It was the highest rated show.
16 million views.
Yeah, it was the highest rated show in a long time.
What are we doing sitting here?
Yep.
We should be on Ellen or something.
It was all the air horn, I think.
The air
that's
horn.
What it was. Kelly and I jumped out of our seats. Oh, God. But anyway, I'm glad you had fun there, Scott.
Yes,
I'm
it was
glad,
fun.
I'm glad to have you back here.
Good to be here.
We're going to be doing some movie reviews. Now, the movie is called, we got the little picture here we're going to put up on the screen.
Yep.
The name of it is The Babadook.
The Babadook.
Babadook.
Yep.
Okay.
No, it's Australian. It depends on how you
It's Australian. Did you ever hear of that film? It's a horror film. You know, that's what he does.
No, I don't. Well, I know that's what he does, but no, I haven't heard of that film.
Really? Yeah. Well, maybe you might want to preview it with us.
Sure.
Matt wants somebody to hold
you
his
should,
hand.
You should record me. I get scared watching.
Well, I do
movies,
too.
So.
I sent a text message to my friend Chrissy because she's all into the horror films.
Yeah.
So I said, if I'm going to watch with anybody, I'm going to watch it with her because at least I'll know when the scary parts are. She'll tell me to close my eyes.
I jump even when it's not scary.
Wait till you hear the air horn.
Okay.
It was his air horn. I like your shirt there, Scott.
Thank
what
you.
Is, what is that? Is
this
that
is
the Joker?
This is just, yep, the Joker. This is the same line from last time, the celebrities.
Yes.
So
okay.
Every time
okay.
a celebrity dies, this guy runs out a new t-shirt. So
wow.
This is the Heath Ledger.
Wow, okay.
Not
how about the Roddy Piper?
I was going to say, I was like,
that's a good idea.
No.
Good transition, too.
Right, good transition. Now, my friend here, Scott Hallam, you know, he's a wrestling fanatic.
I'm not.
He is. He knows everything about it. So I have
that's Roddy
here.
Roddy Piper. Oh my God!
Roddy Piper passed away. Now, this is the Roddy Piper doll. I took it out of the archives.
Oh my God!
You know, this is these are huge.
Get it out of the archives, aka the box under his bed.
We had to go down to the basement for this one. You know, this was down in the basement collection.
Uh-huh.
And I also have the Hulk Hogan.
Oh my God!
The Hulk Hogan that went with it. You see this here?
There's no dust on these.
No.
FYI.
Well, they're collector's items.
Uh-huh.
Now, can you imagine if I didn't take them out of the box? But
there
your favorite
no
Roddy Piper moment. Now, we got the hot rod here, right here on camera. What's the favorite moment?
Do you have a favorite Piper moment? There's only one answer.
Didn't he used to lift up his kilt?
No, what?
No?
What?
I don't remember.
What wrestling were you watching?
You
want
to look under his kilt?
Okay, thanks.
The greatest Piper moment is when he smashed a coconut and Jimmy Superfly snuck his head.
That's right.
How do I not remember that?
He took the coconut
yep.
and he nailed Superfly Jimmy Snuka right in the head.
And then he mashed a banana in his face and
right.
he said a bunch of stuff that you'd
right.
never be able to get
I
away with saying
that.
On TV
right.
now.
We can't even show that.
I was too busy looking at Bret the Hitman Hart. I
yep.
loved him.
Well, this is before him. This was WrestleMania, first WrestleMania. Mm. You know, there he is right
Matt
there.
Matt can't show it, but do yourself a favor and look up
yeah,
Roddy
go,
Piper.
Right, go look up Roddy Piper.
Yeah,
you know, Piper's Pit. With,
what was the date?
I don't remember the date.
Oh,
it was
wow.
the 80s, in the 80s. Like
Cracks
86.
Superfly Snuka with coconut.
Right. Piper's Pit with Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
And,
you
and coconut.
Yes. And actually, Chrissy sent me a message here. We're live on the air.
Said, we can take a caller. Look at that.
We can take a caller here. She'll kill me if I called her. But she said, Scott Hallam told me about it. He loved it. I didn't really like it.
Whoa!
Whoa! So I guess she already saw it.
Excuse me, Siskel and Ebert.
So I'm going to have to talk to her later about
talk
this.
Talk to her later.
And, you know, then we'll talk about it later on. But I had a busy week last week. Besides sitting in the sun for a few days, you know, to get my little tan here that you said is a spray tan, but it's not.
You're glowing.
I'm burnt.
Orange.
Yeah, well, I'm burnt. I was burnt, Heather.
Okay.
Yes, I was all red. Please.
SPF, my friend.
Yeah, well, I don't know.
You're
going to
look like Magda from There's Something About Mary.
Aerosol burn.
That's what happens. But Sunday I went to dinner with Dave Darling. Chief of police here.
Where'd you go?
We went down to Port of Call and Brother Joseph, you know, at the Friary. We all went down. Nice laughs with Dave. Friday, I went to the grand opening at Lacey's. It's their 100th anniversary.
Yeah.
The senator and the assemblyman were there. Senator Amador, Assemblyman Lopez. Legislator wannabe Matt was there. I am running for legislator.
Is that what it says on the sign?
Yeah, that's what it says on the sign.
Legislator
yeah.
wannabe.
Legislator wannabes, part-time talk show host, full-time teacher. You know, that's the.
Can't
just
show
slow.
Your stuff.
Et cetera,
your,
et cetera.
Can't just show your
right. I should have showed my campaign.
Material?
Right. You wait till you see the promos here. Heather.
Huh?
Wait till you see this. I mean,
I'm
you could be the first one to be sporting this on the back of your car.
I am going
there
to put it on there now.
I will give you one.
I am so excited.
Yes, I will give you one of those.
You just
there
hold that
it
up
is.
For the rest of the show.
That's it. That's it. Right there. Overball, Luvera, Brown, and Bulich.
Now here's the other thing that I'm thinking about. Because
yes.
Matt doesn't have the time to do live with Matt every week anymore.
Can't. Yeah, we're wrapping up.
So what we're going to do
weekly schedule.
Is from now on it's going to be pay-per-view live with Matt. $29.99.
We're going to have like some death matches in there?
Huh? Oh, I don't
know. We might have to do some wrestling.
I think if we planned ahead enough, we could have had a fake coconut that I could have cracked them with.
Would have made for good
You have to have a banana, though.
Could have had the bananas, right?
Do you have
no
banana?
Bananas? Nope, no bananas. But we are wrapping up Fly With Matt. This,
Hit him
this
with
is
that
coming
trigger.
To the end. This is coming to the end of our weekly edition. We're still going to have specials. I mean, the people don't want it to end.
No, it can't.
It's not going to end totally, but we can't do a weekly schedule anymore. So our final show is coming up on September 1st. So tune into that. It's a video blog awards. And actually, I have one back here as a little preview.
Here we go.
This is the award right here that some people will be receiving for some favorite moments and different segments that we've been showing. Now, we're going to get to some of them here in a moment. I also wanted to mention my good buddy Kathy Lee Gifford. Her husband Frank passed away. I sent a tweet out about that, you know, when it happened. We were pre-recorded last week. We weren't live last week, Scott.
Shocked.
Nice. We're live this week. So I wanted to, you know, mention that to Kathy Lee as well, that, you know, we're thinking about her. But let's get to some of our segments now. All right, this is why we're all here. Mm-hmm. We want to see it. We're going to go down to the painted piece on Main Street. Here, let's go take a look.
The pigments, the paints are very strongly pigmented, which is why it goes so far and it covers so well. Mm-hmm. One coat is translucent, so you could sort of see through it, so if you want to see the grain of the wood. But if you paint three coats of this onto surfaces, then you have chalkboard.
So, wow!
That's why it's magic.
Really? So this was actually...
That's paint.
Wow.
Yeah. I had a mirror in there, and the mirror broke, so I painted a piece of wood that was behind it with the graphite, and you know, I got many different colors. This is the 4-ounce size, which this can do like a small nightstand,
right?
A little table, a little step stool, or something like that. She was going to go home and do her grandson's nightstand. I painted this one color, and then I painted the second color over it, and then I clear waxed it, and then the reason I clear waxed it is if you're going to distress it, it distresses very easily, but the clear wax makes it not so dusty. So then I lightly sanded it so that the red would show through.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah.
And then I dark waxed it so it changes the color completely. It really tones it down.
Riveting. I know, you'll enjoy that. I went down to 9-Round Fitness.
I haven't checked it out yet.
Really?
I haven't
had
time.
Well, I've got a 30-day free subscription. I need to go down there.
I thought it was for women.
How'd you get that?
No, it's for anybody. Yes, I went down there. I previewed it.
What'd
Let's
you
go take a look.
Sounds good.
This is one I really want to see.
What I tried to do here?
Yep.
And what he didn't mention is they actually had to replace all the punching bags when Matt got done destroying them. And a little known fact about Matt is he actually was originally going to play the Russian in Rocky IV.
That's right.
But they had to time commitments for school and
they, you know, they couldn't meet my demands.
Couldn't get them.
You know, I have a tough contract.
Yeah.
It's a teacher contract. Now, I also took the video blog on the road again. We went down to the Catskill General Store. Look at that. And we're down here at the General Store of Catskill, and we have with us Ashley Seeley.
Hello.
Welcome, Ashley. Thank you.
I'm a gift shop. I have a focus on bath, body, and wellness products.
Nice.
Everything in the store is made in the U.S. It's all handmade products with natural ingredients, okay. All made in small batches by like actual people, which is
nice.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
And we're going to sample, we're going to take a look at some of those products, you know, in a moment.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Find light in the beautiful sea. I chose to be happy. We're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see. A vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're like diamonds in the sky. I knew there would become one right away. Oh, right away. At first sight I felt the energy of sunrise.
All right, Luvera, wind it up. Let's go.
Let's wind it down here. We got things to do, Heather. I mean, I don't have time
for this.
We
have to finish moving.
We got to finish moving. I got to upload this onto YouTube. I mean, we're behind schedule here. Let's get to it. We were cooking with Heather Schindler.
How long is this show?
And Nancy Pommettier. Here we go. Let's go do it.
So, you know, you can, you know, put meat on this and put it on the barbecue,
the
but they're
right out of there,
but,
like,
yep,
okay.
But they're great for fruit.
Uh-huh.
And these little kebabs. So here all we have is some fresh basil.
Fresh, I can smell the basil.
Okay,
yeah, smells,
you gotta love the fresh basil.
Oh, yeah.
Grape tomatoes, we cut them in half, then they absorb the vinaigrette a little bit better.
Right.
And we have small mozzarella balls.
Okay.
Okay, and then we're going to...
Small mozzarella balls.
Nice.
Yes.
Who she likes, I guess.
And then we're going to douse those with some Ken's Light Balsamic Vinaigrette. You can make your own, but this makes it real easy.
What are we doing with the stick?
Okay, so let's. Why don't you thread on a mozzarella ball?
What do you mean by thread?
Well,
put
it on
a
stick and push it down on. Keep
push
going.
Look at that.
You
wow. Okay.
You're still in a restaurant?
Now let's take a, how about we do a tomato?
Tomato on. There's cherry tomato.
Those are nice.
Okay, and a piece of basil.
Piece of basil.
No.
Just
this here.
Just tear it right away.
Just tear
there
a piece
we go.
Off.
Tear a piece off.
I tear a piece
and now
off.
Basically you would just keep doing that.
You repeat it, right?
And you would
repeat
it. It's a pattern.
It's a pattern, right?
It's like a pattern. Again, it can be made ahead.
Mm-hmm.
And you put it in the fridge, and it's actually better if it's been made for even overnight. Yeah, it's great. And then you can just bring it. I actually, a lot of times, make it in the, one of these little travel containers so I don't have to worry about the dish.
Very good.
And it's just perfect. And it's called eclair pie.
Eclair pie. Well,
and
it looks like I'm going to get dirty. That's why I put the eclair.
Okay.
You know?
Okay. So I'm going to give each of you a job.
Okay.
Mr. Luvera there, you're
yes.
going to whisk here together. We had 3 cups of milk.
Whisk.
This is the whisk. I even brought my own, but you told me you had one.
Yes, we do have one here in the studio.
I was very impressed.
All right, what am
so
I doing?
So you have 3 cups of milk. A container of Cool Whip and 2 boxes of vanilla pudding.
Mix
stir that up good.
Stir it up.
And Lenny here is going to take graham crackers and line the bottom of the pan.
This is
going to
look
crackers.
Good for your retirement, Len.
Maybe this is something to do and when I'm retired.
You're going
to
start cooking
I'll start
now.
Dabbling in the kitchen.
There you go. That's right.
You're going to dabble.
I'm
going to
bring the lunch bus to the school next year.
Get the edge of the side.
Oh, how's that? Is that enough?
Don't spill it. Don't spill it.
There you go. Keep going.
Oh,
there
yeah.
you go.
How many layers
perfect.
All right, we're good?
I'm going to dump
okay.
about half of that onto there.
Dump it in.
Yeah.
Okay.
About half.
Now, just
keep, yes.
Push it right in?
Well, you can push it out with the whisk.
Use the yeah.
That's
the
other go. Now we're gonna have Lenny's going to take the graham crackers and do another layer.
Another layer here.
Yeah. So the pudding on there.
We'll mess up his table.
Now what is this pudding, by the way?
This is just vanilla pudding.
Just
you
vanilla
can use
pudding,
vanilla
but it doesn't
French
look
vanilla.
Like pudding. It looks like a cream.
Well, no, I said that in the beginning.
Oh, I must have missed that.
That it's a tub of Cool Whip, 8 ounces of Cool Whip, 3 cups of milk.
I was whisking.
And then
whisking.
two two boxes
good.
Of Cool Whip.
Look at that.
He had made a chocolate sauce with unsweetened cocoa,
mm-hmm.
a quarter cup of milk, a stick of butter, and a cup of sugar. Not exactly low fat. But it's really delicious.
You don't care about
so
that.
So we
not
would
today.
Pour that.
Does it thicken if you let it cool?
It does. So just...
It is thickening a little bit.
Right.
I can feel
so
it on the bottom.
If you want to just
when
do it, put this in the refrigerator,
mm-hmm.
just like an eclair. This hardens to a
oh,
nice
really?
Thick chocolate
okay.
shell.
Oh, wow.
And the graham crackers absorb the pudding.
Wow.
So that it tastes almost like a pastry.
Wow. Okay.
No. No, Scott. He's got it out again.
Wait,
ladies,
don't we have to watch the
ladies and gentlemen.
Movie?
Please, no.
It's loud.
I knew it was coming, too. I knew it was coming. Either. I saw him grab it. I saw, you know, he goes and grabs, he shakes it a little bit, too, before he...
I didn't see it. I'm like, out of the loop here.
Kelly, that was for you, honey.
All right, I'll leave it over there. It's
leave it over there. Right. I mean, I'm getting a little nervous here. Thank you, Scott, for joining us, Heather.
Always
a pleasure to have you back here. You too, Scott. We're coming to the end. Now, next week is our last show of this third season. That's it. 3 years I've been doing Live with Matt. Next week's the last show of the season. Our new season is going to start on September 1st. And we're going to have our Live with Matt video blog award show. And then we're going to go to our monthly specials from there.
You lasted longer than Hannibal on NBC.
Yeah, 3 years, please. And we're still going strong.
We're going.
Did they cancel it?
Yes, they did.
You know, I'd still be going, but I've got a lot of things going on.
Got stuff to do.
Got stuff to do. I'll meet you on the campaign trail. Here we go. Have a good week, everyone.
Bye.
Want to blow the air one more time?
Yes.
On the way out the door. Let's go.